Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you, Mr. Mueller, for being here today. Mr. Mueller, is it accurate to say your investigation found no evidence that members of the Trump campaign were involved in the theft or publication of Clinton campaign-related emails?
Yeah. Can you read, or can you repeat the question?
Is it accurate to say your investigation found no evidence that members of the Trump campaign were involved in the theft or publication of the Clinton campaign-related emails?
I don't know. Well,
volume one, page five, the investigation did not establish that members of the Trump campaign conspired or coordinated with the Russian government in its election interference activities. So it would therefore be inaccurate, based on this, to describe that finding as open to doubt, that finding being that a Trump campaign was involved with theft or publication of the Clinton campaign emails. Are you following that, sir?
I do believe I'm following it, but it is that portion or that matter, it does not fall within our jurisdiction fall within our investigation.
Well, basically what your report says, volume one, page five, I just want to be clear that open to doubt is how the committee Democrats described this finding in their minority views of our 2018 report. And it kind of flies in the face of what you have in your report. But so is it accurate also to say the investigation found no documentary evidence that George Papadopoulos told anyone affiliated with the Trump campaign about Joseph Mifsud's claims that the Russians had dirt on candidate Clinton?
Let me turn that over to Mr. Sadley, if I can.
I'd like to ask you, sir, this is your report, and that's what I'm basing this on.
And then could you repeat the question for me again?
Yeah, is it accurate to say the investigation found no documentary evidence that George Papadopoulos told anyone affiliated with the Trump campaign about Joseph Mifsud's claims that the Russians had dirt on candidate Clinton?
I believe it appearing in the report that it's accurate.
Okay, so in the report it says no documentary evidence that Papadopoulos shared this information with the campaign. It's therefore inaccurate to conclude that by the time of the June 9, 2016 Trump Tower meeting, quote, the campaign was likely already on notice via George Papadopoulos's contact with Russian agents that Russia, in fact, had damaging information on Trump's opponent. Would you say that that is inaccurate to say that it's likely already?
I could direct you to the report.
Well, I appreciate that because the Democrats jumped to this incorrect collusion in their minority views, again, which contradicts what you have in your report. I'm concerned about a number of statements I'd like you to clarify because a number of Democrats have made some statements that I have concerns with, and maybe you can clear them up. So a member of this committee said President Trump was a Russian agent after your report was publicly released. That statement is not supported by your report, correct?
That is accurate. It's not supported.
Multiple Democrat members have asserted that Paul Manafort met with Julian Assange in 2016 before WikiLeaks released DNC emails, implying Manafort colluded with Assange. Because your report does not mention finding evidence that Manafort met with Assange, I would assume that means you found no evidence of this meeting. Is that assumption correct?
I'm not certain I agree with that assumption.
But you make no mention of it in your report. Would you agree with that?
Yes, I would agree with that.
Okay, Mr. Mueller, does your report contain any evidence that President Trump was enrolled in the Russian system of compromat as a member of this committee once claimed?
Well, what I can speak to is information and evidence that we picked up as the special counsel, and I think that's accurate as far as it goes.
Thank you. I appreciate that. So let's go for a second to scope. Did you ask the Department of Justice to expand the scope of the special counsel's mandate related to August 2nd, 2017 or August 20th, 2017 scoping memoranda?
Well, there, without looking at the memoranda, I could not answer that
question. Well, let me ask you, did you ever make a request to expand your office's mandate at all?
Generally, yes.
And was that ever denied?
I'm not going to speak to that.
It goes to
internal deliberations.
Well, I'm just trying to understand process. Is expanding the scope come from the acting attorney general Rosenstein, or does it come from you, or can it come from either?
I'm not going to discuss any other alternatives.
Thank you, Mr. Mueller.